Hi, today we are going to discuss about one important cranial nerve, the olfactory nerve. It's a very simple nerve. This is the pathway of the olfactory nerve. I'll explain you in detail. So olfactory means, olfaction means smell, right? So we have to concentrate in the nose. Which part of the nose it is? You can see the vomer, you can see the perpendicular plate of ethmoid. So obviously it is the nasal septum, right? So on the nasal septum, you can see the yellow color structure, that is your olfactory nerves. These nerves, now you will go to the next picture. Here you can see the mucous membrane, which is red and pink in color inside your nose, right? So in that you have the olfactory cells. These cells, they do have their receptors, and these receptors, they go up as comes out as olfactory nerve rootlets. These rootlets, though, they pierce or they come through the cribriform plate of ethmoid. So the student should know where is the cribriform plate of ethmoid. This is the skull cranial cavity, and here can you see the foramen, multiple perforated foramen? This is the cribriform plate of ethmoid. Through that, all the olfactory rootlets will be, cribriform means sieve like, that's why it has multiple rootlets, and these rootlets are coming out. And then above, inside, you have the brain, and cerebral is here, and frontal lobe of the cerebral hemisphere is here. So in the inferior aspect of the frontal lobe of the cerebral hemisphere, you have something called as olfactory bulb. So now what happens, look at this olfactory bulb. In the proximal part of the olfactory bulb, you have some important cells by the name mitral cells, and some accessory cells called tufted cells and the granular cells. All these cells will be present, it will be there on the proximal part of the olfactory bulb. Now what happens, these olfactory rootlets, they go and they synapse with the mitral cell dendrites, and the axons from the dendrites, they go and forms the tract called the olfactory tract. So the from the distal aspect, you have the olfactory tract, right? Now the olfactory tract is coming here. So it has two striae. Number one is called as medial striae, and the other one is called as lateral striae. Understood? Now the medial striae, both the sides, they join together and forms the anterior commissure. So what happens to the lateral striae? Lateral striae comes here, and then look at this picture. Lateral striae, it ends up in two areas. One is the primary olfactory cortex, another one is the secondary olfactory cortex. Primary olfactory cortex, where it is present? It is present near the area called amygdala. Amygdala is a nucleus. Just in and around the amygdala, it is called as peri-amygdaloid area. That area, it will come and array. And another one is called pre-piriform cortex. It is also nearby only. So it comes and lies. But the student should know where is the amygdala. Sorry. So this is the area where you have the amygdala. So you have the hippocampus. Hippocampus. Fornix, the tunnel, separate chapter. So hippocampus is here. So just near the hippocampus in the inferior lobe, you have the amygdala. So amygdala is this area where you have the primary olfactory area, and next to that, just behind that, you have where the inferior that collateral sulcus ends. That area you will be having uncus. Everybody knows uncus, right? So where the inferior part, collateral sulcus and the collateral gyrus, parahippocampal gyrus, the gyrus in the inferior lobe, in the temporal part of the cerebral hemisphere, is called as parahippocampal gyrus. This parahippocampal gyrus ends, that area is called as uncus. Near the uncus only you have the entorhinal cortex or secondary olfactory area. So primary olfactory area is peri-amygdaloid, secondary olfactory area is near the uncus. So these areas are interrelated. That's why what happens, this is the olfactory bulb. So olfactory bulb comes here, and it is related to all these areas. That's why this amygdaloid hippocampus are related to the emotions and the limbic system memory. That's why memory, some bad smell means we have that memory, okay? So those memories are related to the olfactory, and the thing is emotions. So if some good smell is there, mood elevation is there, it is also related to the olfactory tract and the amygdala nucleus. So there is some relation between the limbic system and the olfactory. Understood? This is about the important pathway. So while writing the pathway, you have to write olfactory receptors. They synapse with the mitral and tufted cell, and they are present in the proximal part of the olfactory bulb, distal part of the olfactory bulb, medial and lateral olfactory striae comes out, Medial stray form joints with opposite side and forms the anterior commissure. Lateral stray ends up in the pre-piriform area, perimedullary area, that is called as primary olfactory cortex, and the entorhinal area is the secondary olfactory area, area number 28 near the uncus. So this is about the pathway of the olfactory. So what happens if the somebody is having common cold, means both the nostrils will be affected. So both the side nose rootlets will be olfactory rootlets will be affected. So both the sides the patient will not be able to recognize the smell. So what is it called as bilateral anosmia? Anosmia means absence of smell, not able to identify. So bilateral anosmia means it's for common cold. But if there is any fracture in the anterior cranial fossa, that time also both the sides olfactory rootlets will be out. Okay, fracture in the anterior cranial fossa. So obviously both side rootlets will be out. That time also they will be having bilateral anosmia. But some people they will be having tumor in the only one side tumor. So what will happen? This will compress the olfactory bulb on the corresponding side. So they will be having unilateral anosmia. Okay, so look at this. This is anosmia, absence of smell, and here is the exact pathway. You can see from the nasal septum, olfactory rootlets are going. Here is the area I showed. Olfactory bulb is present in the inferior part. Look at this. So if there is any damage one side, it may lead to unilateral anosmia. Common cold and all, it will lead to bilateral anosmia, right? So this is about the olfactory nerve. The next video we are going to see the optic, the second cranial nerve. Thank you.